Welcome to Section 4 of the MLA Works Cited Page Basics Workshop. In this section, we will focus on citing articles on the Works Cited page. We will be looking at the MLA container system again, but we will be adding information from container 2. Don't panic. Once you see the pattern, it will become easier. To review, citations are broken down into author, title, container 1, and container 2. Author, title, and container 1 should be recognizable since we covered those in the Citing Books video. Let's take another look at the complete MLA Works Cited format flowchart. We've used two elements from container 1 so far, publisher and publication date. With articles, we will be using different elements, but the flow should be familiar. In addition, since most of the articles you will be citing will come from the library databases, container 2 is going to come into play. And now on to the basic article format. We'll keep a copy of the flowchart handy as we review the container 1 information. Here goes. The citation starts with the author. You'll use the same format as you did with books. Last name, comma, first name, period. Next comes the title of the article. Notice that the title appears in quotation marks. Use capital letters like you would use for any title, and make sure that the period is inside the quotation marks. Container 1 is where things are going to be a bit different. The first container 1 element is the title of the container, in this case, the title of the periodical. A periodical can be a magazine, an academic journal, a newspaper, or other source that is published at regular intervals. Notice how the title of the periodical is in italics, followed by a comma. Each element in container 1 will be separated by a comma. The next element is the version. In the world of periodicals, this translates into the volume number, followed by a comma. After version is the number. In periodical talk, this is the issue number followed by a comma. Following the number is the date of publication, followed by a comma. Finally, the last element of container 1 is the range of pages, followed by a period. We'll look at some real-world examples of article citations so you can see what container 1 looks like. Since the articles you find in the library databases are housed within a database, you'll also need to include some information from container 2. In this case, the title of the container will be the title of the database. Notice that the database title is in italics, followed by a comma. The final element from container 2 is the location. For articles from a library database, the location will be either the DOI, or digital object identifier, or the URL, followed by a period. Most recent articles will use a DOI, which is a unique identifier for digital published content. With all the older articles that were published before the use of DOIs, you will need to use the URL or permalink for the article. When we look at the real-world examples, you'll see how the DOI fits in. Okay, let's take a look at those real-world examples. As a reminder, the basic article format is author, last name, comma, first name, period. Title of article in quotation marks with a period inside. Here is the container 1 information. Title of periodical in italics followed by a comma. Version or volume number followed by a comma. Number or issued followed by a comma. Publication date followed by a comma. And location or page range followed by a period to indicate the end of container 1. Next up, container 2. database title in italics followed by a comma. Then DOI or URL followed by a period to indicate the end of container 2. Let's see what that looks like for an article with one author. We start with the author last name, comma, first. For this article, that is Brandel, comma, Shauna M, period. Next is the article title. In this case, that is Games, Movies, and Zombies, Making IR Fun for Everyone. Remember that article titles are in quotation marks. Use capital letters as you would for a title, and make sure that the period is within the quotation marks. The container 1 information is Journal of Political Science Education in italics, followed by a comma. The version or volume is 16. Notice that MLA uses the abbreviation VOL period to denote volume. Next is the number or issue. In this case, it is 4, followed by a comma. Notice how MLA uses the abbreviation NO to denote the issue number. The date of publication is next. In this case, it is October 2020, followed by a comma. Finally comes the location. In MLA, the location is the page or range of pages for the article. For a single page, use the abbreviation P period. For a longer article than one page, use PP period and the range of page numbers. You will see the period after the page range. Finally, let's look at the information for container 2. For this article, it is the database EBSCOhost in italics, followed by a comma. The last element is the DOI, followed by a period. Okay, the elements should be a bit familiar by now. Let's take a look at an article by two authors. We won't spend as much time on this one since it's the same format as you learn for books with two authors. Here goes. The authors are Hallgren, Marcus, and David A. Buchanan. The article is in quotation marks. The Dark Side of Group Behavior, Zombie Apocalypse Lessons, period, end quote. The container 1 elements are Academy of Management Perspectives, in italics, comma, volume 34, comma, number 4, comma, November 2020, comma, PP period, 434 through 57, period. The container 2 elements are EBSCOhost, comma, and the DOI, period. Remember, journal and database titles are in italics. Now we move on to an article with more than two authors. Spindle, comma, Nathan B., period, comma, et al., period. The title of the article is in quotation marks with the period inside the quotes. For container 1, the elements are the journal title in italics, followed by the volume, comma, issue, comma, publication date, comma, and page range, period. For container 2, the elements are the database in italics, comma, DOI, period. Finally, let's look at an article that doesn't have a DOI. Here goes. We have last name, comma, first name of the author, followed by a period. The title of the article in quotation marks with the period inside the quotes. For container 1, journal title in italics, comma, volume, comma, issue, comma, date, comma, page range, period. Remember, volume is abbreviated as VOL, period, and issue is abbreviated as NO, period. Finally, we have container 2, the database title in italics, comma, followed by the URL for the article since it doesn't have a DOI. Whew, Is it looking more familiar now? Are you starting to recognize the order? What goes in quotation marks? What needs italics? If you know which is punctuated how, you're getting there. If you're comfortable with citing articles, please move on to the quiz.